Hi everybody, my name is Caesar, and in this video, I'm gonna show you how to activate and how to gather DNA for the Ancestry DNA test kit. Let's get right into it. Here's everything that's gonna come in the Ancestry DNA test kit. First thing you're gonna have are the instructions. You're gonna have your collection bag. You're gonna have the collection tube along with the blue solution. And lastly, you're gonna have a small box so you can mail out your DNA test kit. Do not, I repeat, do not eat.
Why don't you eat up and we'll tell you.
Drink.
It's not my first, or my last.
Chew gum.
Violet, you're turning violet, Violet.
Or smoke.
Smoke break.
30 minutes before giving your saliva sample. A good tip is to brush your teeth 30 minutes before you give your saliva sample. That way, if there's anything in your teeth, like if you ate a burger and french fries, and there might be like a little piece of french fries stuck in your teeth, and you might mess up the results because it'll come back saying that you're part French because of the french fry. Get it? French fry? It was a joke, you could laugh. Okay, sorry, no more cheesy jokes. Let's get right back into it. First step is we're gonna have to activate our kit online. We could do this by computer or phone. In my case, we're gonna use the computer. We're gonna have to activate the kit at ancestry.com. It's fast and simple. You're gonna create a free account with your name, email, and password. Go to activate a kit in the upper right-hand corner. Enter the 15-digit activation code, which is located on the back side of the instructions or on the actual collection tube. Fill out info like your name, last name, birth year, and gender. You have to consent to Ancestry DNA processing terms. Next page, you could give consent or decline to participate in a research study. Ancestry asks if you would like to be linked to family members. And lastly, hit the activate kit button. Add phone number if you wish to receive status and updates on your DNA test kit. We're gonna open up the collection tube. Okay, so here goes the fun part. We're gonna have to fill the tube with saliva up to the black wavy line. And that does not include the saliva bubbles. So here we go. This is the nastiest part of the test, but something we gotta do. Almost there. It's important, it says not to overfill, so you're just supposed to go to that wavy line.
Six and a half hours later.
Okay, so here we go. I'm gonna show you. It's kind of nasty, but this is what you gotta do. It's a little bit above the wavy line. You could see the bubbles. Okay, we can see the blue solution here. Okay, I'm taking off the funnel. You can see the threads where you're gonna be screwing the solution in, and the solution is just supposed to plop right in there. And it's supposed to stabilize the DNA. Okay, you can see it. All right, now it says to shake it for 5 seconds. 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, 4-1000, 5-1000. Now we're gonna place the tube in the collection bag and seal it off. like so. So now we're gonna take our sample and we're gonna place it in the box like so. We have some adhesive tape here. And we're just gonna seal the box. Just like so. So it says no postage necessary if mailed inside the United States. So we don't have to put any stamps or we don't have to pay for it. We're just gonna put it in a mailbox and it's gonna be good to go. If you would like to see the results of my Ancestry DNA test, you're gonna have to wait 6 to 8 weeks, just like I am. So make sure you subscribe, hit the bell so you get all my notifications. Make sure you hit that like if this video helped you out in any way. And if you have any questions whatsoever, go ahead and put them in the comment box below and I will get back to you. See you on the next video.